Hi there, Plasticjunky here with another movie segment, Predator. This Predator line is from Kenner. Kenner made these in the 90s, and a lot of 90s figures now are starting to be sought after. And I love the movie because not only Arnold's in it. Hello, Arnold. My name is Arnold. Stay down. Down.
Get to the chopper!
Get to the chopper! Yes, I'm happy he's back in the movies.
He's single, huh?
What?
He got divorced from
his... And he got divorced! Good for you, Arnold! Get the shit, bitch! Anyways, this is a special segment of Predator. This is the Predator 2 disc. And there you get it. With nice art. Beautiful. Hope none of you people that make the DVDs are going to be mad at me, but we're going to put the score too, so... Fortunately, this is just for collectors. For the geeks and freaks like me. I'm a freak, I'm a geek, whatever you want to call me. You call me whatever you want. I mean, you call me Banana Boy, I don't give a shit. Because I am Plastic Junkie. I've got a lot of things to show my fans and the world. Predator movie. How many skulls I give it? I give it... This is a hard thing for me to do. But no, actually, yes, I give it five skulls. Why? It's awesome movie. To do this in early 80s, and to get good special effects when they were in the jungle, and Jesse the Body Ventura died, and their guts are hanging and everything. Oh, please, that was awesome. It was freaking amazing. Why wouldn't they do that? 80s movies, I gotta admit, the special effects were amazing. Especially Stan Winston's. We're gonna do some of Stan Winston's. God make him rest in peace, he passed away. Stan Winston figures I have. Yes, I do. I have the She Creature. I have a bunch of them. When they were gonna do those. Oh, they fell down. Oh well, what else is new? Okay, so Predator 80s movies are amazing because the special effects were all done without CIG.
CG.
CG?
CG.
Okay, CG.
Computer graphics.
Computer graphics. Thank you, Godfather. That's why he's here. He knows everything about computers. Remember this, huh? Five skulls I give this movie. Now, we're going to talk about the figures. Oh, look at that. He fell down. Okay. We're going to start with the first one that I have here. This one's called the Ambush Predator. He was a special edition. He was a mail away. And he was... that's why they called him Ambush, because he was transparent. See? That's the Ambush Predator. Then we have this jabroni that fell down. Yes, jabroni. He always falls this banana. This one is... Glow-in-the-dark Predator. I don't remember his name, but it's the only one I don't remember his name. There's his face, see? He goes in the dark, which is one of my favorite things. I love glow-in-the-dark figures. They're awesome figures. We're going to do one day a segment in the dark with only glow-in-the-dark figures. Believe it or not. Let's put him on the floor, because he's always falling.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Coming back to this one. I didn't show you something. I'm sorry. See? He has a chest plate that comes out. They took... The main body, the ones that they always use, and they just made it transparent, and it was Ambush Predator. This was a mail away. I paid a lot for it, but you know what? Who cares? It's a nice figure. It's amazing. It's not one of my favorite one of the whole line. I'll show you which one my favorite one is. And that's going to be the last one I show you. Whoopsie! Okay. That's okay. Now, we have ones that I call clones. You have a Savage Predator, and you have a Lava Predator. See? Even if I take out the mask, they're the same figure. I call them clones. They reissue it. Lava, Savage Predator. Look at the... You see? Just a different paint job, you see? It's the same figure, same concept. You shoot the little button, the little thing goes flying. Lava Predator, Savage Predator. Then, we have... This is from the 2-pack. It's an Alien versus Predator 2-pack. Everything's falling. Okay. These guys don't want to be showing off. It's okay. It's all good. This one's nice. This one, again, Kenner made these in the 90s, and this one, they are, the paint job is amazing. Again, they took the same figure, but they put the original weapon from the movie, the original mask from the movie. They made it really, really nice. You can see that you could still, if you really notice it, it's still the same figure because it has little, hold on there. It's the same figure, see? Same figure, just repainted, you see? They always do that, which is okay. This is one of my favorite ones, but still not my favorite. Then, we have my favorite one that's on the floor. This one, this one you have to see the mask. This is called Laser Shock Predator. Listen. From there. See, the minute it makes noise, the minute you go, and it shoots. So, yeah, yes, I'm going to throw you the bullet, okay?
Jeez.
Shoots, just like this. There you go.
Son of a...
relax, you throw me a bulletin when you do your segment of Gundam Robots. Yes, we're going to do Gundam Robots with the Godfather. I'm going to be filming, he'll be do Gundam.
Have my revenge.
Yes, you will. So, good to have revenge. Laser Shock Predator, one of their exclusive ones, really, really nice. This one took me a long time to find that I bought it in 94. I bought 3 or 4 of them, sold the rest, kept him, and he's the only one I kept out of the ones I had. Still one of my favorites. Now we're getting down to the nitty gritty. Then we have, this is called the Ultimate Predator. This was a big one they made. See, it came with the thing, they made it more articulated. It comes with the little slice and dice thing, they call it. I don't know the names, but it's really nice. It's not too articulated. It doesn't move here. It moves only here. The head doesn't move, and that's it. Nothing else. Not even the arms move. Look, not even the hands. No articulation. Nothing. Just the arms. But that's what they call the Ultimate Predator because they repainted and made it bigger. Then they made a two-pack of this from KB, which they repainted him and the alien against each other. Then they made another two-pack where you get Alien versus Corporal Hicks. But that's for another story. That's for another segment of just aliens from Kenner. That's another line I like. Now, my favorite one of them all, we're getting down to it. Then I'll tell you how much score I give, skulls I give this. This is Clan Leader Predator. This one is freaking awesome. This figure is beautiful. Look at the details on him. How nice he is. Look, okay? Watch this feature. He grabs you. I have to show the mask. This is how it looks underneath. See, without the mask. The colors are gorgeous. Yeah, I opened them. They came out in 1994, these figures. Big mask. He's the leader of the Predators from the Kenner line. Clan Leader Predator. See? He grabs his bad guy, the bad guys, the aliens. Just grab like this. And he brings them towards him. And then he slices and dices them with his weapon here. Oh, it's upside down. Oh, boy. Sorry. Where is it now? Okay. This is my favorite, one of my favorite lines too. The 90 figures, I like them. Tick, Adam's Family, there's so many, I was about to say Food Fighters. Oops, Food Fighters are the 80s actually, so 90s. My apologies. But look, this feature he has here, he has extendable legs to make him taller. You just push down, and you pull up, and he makes him taller. See? Predator Clan Leader. Beautiful figure. I give the figures, I'm going to be honest, they're not the nicest Predators they ever made, so I still give it a 3.5 skull. That's generous from 1 to 5 of skulls. Anyways, Plasticjunky out, leaving you with Predator. If you like Predator, watch the new one that came out a while ago called Predators. I still didn't get it for myself, but I have a big, huge collection of DVDs, and I have a lot to put on my list. So, Plasticjunky out, next segment. One of my favorite TV shows, Xena. This is gonna be the first segment for girls, but I'm gonna still be doing it. So, Plasticjunky out. Love you. Talk to you later, man.